waking up knowing there's a reason. All my dreams come alive. Life is for living with you. I've made my decision. You lift me up, fill my eyes with wonder. For every young in your love, this freedom's untainted. With you, no moment is wasted. See the sun now bursting through the clouds, black and white, turns to color all around. All is new in the Savior I have found. This is living now. Nothing like living with you. This life you created, I choose. See the sun now bursting through the clouds, black and white, turns to color all around. All is new in the Savior I have found. This is living now. This is living now.
Love, if it was, am I living it? What? Do I live in it? Yeah. So astounding. Love is an ocean, you can drown me. The sweet embrace, the lovely taste, I taste and see. I'm under grace, the place to be. It means I'll never need an umbrella. I'm cool in the cold, in the hot weather. Whether or never I ever understand, I'm a man in the hands of great plans. I stand with faith and a life I never known to touch. And still I saw my clutch, but I'm like, what's the dream of? What's the hope in? What's to die for? Live to no end. This is living. The life I've been given is a gift. If I'm a living, I'm a living to death. So what's the dream of? What's the hope in? What's to die for? And live to no end. This is living. The life I'm a give is a gift. If I'm a living, I'm a living to death. Yeah.
Devoted like a ring of solid gold, like a vow that is tested, like a covenant of old. Your love is enduring through the winter rain and beyond the horizon. With mercy for today, faithful you have been, and faithful you will be. You pledge yourself to me, and it's why I sing. Your praise will ever be on my lips, ever be on. Your praise will ever be on my lips, ever be on my lips. Your praise will ever be on my lips, ever be on my lips. Your praise will ever be on my lips.
Your praise will ever be on my lips, ever be on my lips. Fantastic.
I got my guns.
I love it. So, we'll give you a countdown. I'm going to go 3, 2, 1. Gunge yourself. Oh, that is the kick gunge. That's amazing.
Oh, this is so thick.
That is incredibly thick. Looks like green mashed potato. I love it.
Put way too much cornflour in it.
Can we get a close up of Alison's face? That's fantastic. Look at that.
Thanks, guys.
Brilliant.
I'll find out who voted for me.
Find out and somehow get revenge.
And I'll come at you with the rest of it.
Brilliant. Thanks, Alison. Right, I'm going to switch to Dan now.
This is him at the moment.
A bit like you're ready to go swimming. I love it.
He's prepared.
I'm just doing my prayers.
Okay. Right.
So.
Got a handy mum.
Ella May, do you want to give the countdown?
Yeah, okay, ready? 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go.
That is incredible.
Look at our girls now.
That's brilliant. To a life unlike before, the father's heart is beckoning, and I can't resist no more. Leave me in the ways of devotion. I don't wanna get caught in the motions. My heart is only for you, Lord. So I let go and I let love show me life like it's supposed to be. An oasis, here awaits all the freedom I'll ever need. Now I'm alive. Oh, I love. Oh, I love. When I let go and I fall out. Oh, I love. Oh, I love. When I let go and I fall out.
Got a crowd for it as well. 5. Oh, we got a 5. 4. 2.
The waiting's wise.
1.
Oh! That's a lot thicker than I thought. Oh, that is so good.
Fantastic. I've got my gun.
I love it. So, we'll give you a countdown. I'm going to go 3, 2, 1. Gun yourself. Oh, that is the kick gun. That's amazing.
This is so thick.
That is incredibly thick. It's like green mashed potato. I love it.
Basically, put way too much cornflour in it.
Can we get a close up of Alison's face? That's fantastic. Look at that.
Thanks, guys.
Brilliant.
I'll find out who voted for me.
Find out and somehow get revenge.
And I'll come at you with the rest of it.
Brilliant. Thanks, Alison. Right, I'm going to switch to Dan now.
This is him at the moment.
Bit like you're ready to go swimming. I love it.
He's prepared.
I'm just saying my prayers.
Okay. Right.
So.
Got a hand deep, Mum.
Ella Mae, do you want to give the countdown?
Yeah, okay, ready? 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go!
That is incredible.
Look at our girls now.
That's brilliant. Hi everyone, welcome to Youth Online. Online. Look at me, I can point at things. Hope you're all doing okay. It's been lovely to see you guys in the week doing cell groups. Those are happening this week as well. But excited this evening to spend some time gathering with you all. We're going to have a game, we're going to do dizzy burpees. Great fun, so get yourself psyched for that. We've got a bit of worship, which is going to be lovely to praise God together. And we've got James talking about the next bit of the Lord's Prayer with us as well. And then at the end of the service, we've got a gunging. So you get to vote between Orla and Maddie as to who's going to get gunged this week. And we're going to do a new thing where we're going to have our Youth Hangout Half Hour. So we're all going to join on Zoom if you want to at the end. You can watch the Instagram live feed through that as well and have a little bit of a chat just to chill out afterwards. But keen to see what you guys have all been up to this week, or next week as well. Send me anything you've been up to, anything exciting, videos, photos. I'd love it to be in next week's service. Here's what I've been up to this week. Hi guys, so I have made the world's greatest slide, a very safe slide by the looks of it, and I'm definitely not going to get injured going down it. Lift off is a slow one. Anyone else for a go? Great fun, I love it. Managed to not break anything, which is always a success. So this week, if you do anything, if you want to do anything that you wouldn't have normally done, that is safe, have some fun. If you video it, if you photo it, if you make something, if you do a painting, make a cake, make a slide, send it in if you want to feature it in next week's service. Really keen to see what you guys get up to in the week. Okay, Let's come together as in a time of worship now where we're going to focus on God. Whether that's sat down, lying down, stood up, dancing, whatever gets you to the place where you are connecting with God. And let's worship Him together. Over to Ash.
Oh Lord my God, when I in awesome wonder consider all the works thy hand hath made, I see the stars, I hear the mighty thunder, thy power throughout the universe displayed. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee, how great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee, how great thou art, how great thou art. When through the woods and forest glades I wander, and hear the birds sing sweetly in the trees, when I look down from lofty mountain grandeur, and hear the brook and feel the gentle breeze, then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee, how great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee, how great thou art, how great thou art. And when I think that God his Son not sparing sent him to die, I scarce can take it in that on the cross my burden gladly bearing, he bled and died to take away my sin. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, how great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee, how great thou art, how great thou art. When Christ shall come with shout of acclamation and take me home, what joy shall fill my heart. Then shall I bow in humble adoration and there proclaim, my God, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee, how great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee, and how great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee, how great thou art,
how great thou art,
how great thou art.
Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee, how great thou art, how great thou art.
Thanks, Ash. I love worshipping with you guys. Really hope you guys enjoy that and connect with God through it as well. So now we're going to play a game. The game tonight is Dizzy Burpees. This is how it works.
Find some space. You're going to spin around for 30 seconds. And then you're going to do as many burpees as you can.
So, get your space ready. Make sure you've got nothing breakable next to you. You're not going to fall over. You're not going to trample on any friends or family. And let's go. So, you have 30 seconds to spin and then 15 seconds to do as many as you can. In 3, 2, 1, go. Excellent, guys. Over to James.
Hey, guys. Hope you're doing really, really well. So today we're going to talk about the next part of the Lord's Prayer. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. A really, really key part of the Lord's Prayer. So, what do we think about when we think about God's kingdom? Well, if you're anything like me and you've seen a Disney film, you'll know that iconic intro of a castle. So, when I think about God's kingdom, I find this imagery somewhat helpful. Look, it's not a perfect metaphor by any means, but it does show a physical kingdom that has an impact on the world around it. Now, the main difference here is that the Disney castle isn't real, but God's kingdom absolutely is. So, what does it mean to us for God's kingdom to come to earth? And are we meant to do anything about it? Okay, so before I answer those questions, I'm going to get into a topic called kingdom theology. It can get quite complicated, but I think it is so, so exciting. Because how we view the kingdom of God can literally shape the way we live every part of our lives. Look, I know why that sounds scary. The first time I heard that, that freaked me out. But I hope by the end of this, you're not freaked out anymore, but you're really, really, really excited. So, we need to start with the Lord's Prayer itself. When Jesus was teaching the 12 apostles the Lord's Prayer, he knew what their understanding of kingdom was. For them, a kingdom was an earthly reign, and whatever the king of a kingdom stood for, it affected the entire reach of their kingdom. So, if a king of a kingdom stood for chocolate fudge and sundaes, the entire kingdom's identity could revolve around having chocolate fudge on a sundae. To be honest, that doesn't sound too great to me. I'm not a sweet tooth, but some of you, that may be your heaven. Okay, this may seem somewhat obvious, but this is where it gets absolutely insane. Jesus said that God's kingdom should come to earth. This can mean many things, but to me, it shows that he wants God's kingdom to impact all of Earth. This idea would have been absolutely insane. Why does an all-powerful, all-knowing being care about the physical world around us? Don't we just all die and go off to some faraway land of the clouds anyway? No, absolutely not. Scripture teaches us that one day we will be raised in new and better bodies, in a new heaven and a new earth, the full completion of God's kingdom, where all his plans for the world are finally seen in all their glory. I believe that the new earth will reflect our earth, just not corrupted by sin. Our earth may look like a fuller, more modernized version of the Garden of Eden. So what does this mean to us? Well, it absolutely doesn't mean that we can sit around and wait for God to fix everything. Yes, God technically can fix everything without our help, but why would he? Christianity is about a relationship with God. God doesn't want to build his kingdom without our help. He desperately, desperately wants us to be a part of the process. Philippians 3 teaches us that we are citizens of heaven. So if we are citizens of heaven, we have a responsibility to witness that. If we are citizens of the kingdom of God, we need to live like that. So if I have a passport with me, I don't have it on me right now, but I do have a passport as a citizen of South Africa, you'll be thankful to know, not here illegally. That passport means that I represent the nation of South Africa. Many of you will have British passports, and it means that you represent Britain. And that means that you need to abide by the laws and statutes of England. I need to abide by the laws and statutes of South Africa. What I do reflects on South Africa. What you do reflects on England. And what we all do reflects on the kingdom of God. God is so concerned with every aspect of the world around us. He cares about the environment, he cares about social justice, he cares about the rise of homelessness, he cares about the sick and the afflicted. As citizens of God's kingdom, we need to show the world what his reign really means. And we have the responsibility to make the earth look more like God's kingdom. We need businesses that glorify God, we need arts and entertainment that bring real change to the world around us. We need advocates for the environment showing that we can't treat God's creation like a piece of rubbish. God made all of us with certain gifts and passions, and this is not by a mistake. God wants to use your talents and passions to help bring his kingdom to earth. And this affects every single one of us. Whether we want to be a musician, a businessman, a lawyer, a chef, an actuary, a football player, whatever it is, whatever we're passionate about, whatever gets us up in the morning, God wants to use you for the good in the world. Guys, I need to stop now because if I don't, I'm going to go on a massive rant that could last quite literally for hours. Nobody wants that. I don't want that. Lord knows you don't want that. But if I can leave you with anything today, I want to leave you with this. You are a citizen of God's kingdom. You have the privilege of transforming the world around you to reflect that. Your gifts, talents, passions, hopes, and dreams are so important to the kingdom of God. In fact, they are crucial. Guys, I hope you have a superb week. Bye for now.
Amazing. I love that, James. I love that we're all part of God's heavenly kingdom, and he wants us to bring that down. He wants us to be demonstrating what that kingdom is to everyone around us, whether that's helping a neighbour, whether that's calling your grandma to help her bake something, who knows? That's amazing, though. I love that. So, this week, you've got to think about how you can be sharing the kingdom of God with those around you. Yeah, let's pray. Okay, cell groups are on this week. They're all here on the screen. If you don't know what's going on, you're not part of one, but you want to be, drop me a message, put it in the chat, ask one of us. Cell group leaders are written on the side as well, so you know who's going to be leading it. This week, we're going to be doing a youth bake-along on Friday. So get yourself signed up for that if you want. It's on Church Suite. Your parents have got an email about it as well, or you have. We are also doing our live gunging in a second. So that's on Instagram. You can go on to Instagram live if you'd like. Or we're doing our youth hangout half hour. So straight after this, I'll put the link for the Zoom meeting in the chat right there. You can join in with that, have a chat, have a chill out. You can also, James is gonna stream the gunging on there as well. So you can see either Orla or Maddie getting gunged, winning. And make sure you voted if you've not. But yeah, have a great week, guys, and send me what you're doing this week.
Oh. family and your children and their children and their children. May his favor be upon you and a thousand generations and your family and your children and their children and their children. May his favor.